Welcome to Speak of Hanalei. So, would you like to share your impressions, any kind of experience for your speech?
In my case, I've been a member at Toastmasters Club for over 8 years. You're a member at Toastmasters, right? In the early period, I had much fear in public speeches, but I could be changed into the person who can enjoy the thrill of public speeches, including impromptu speeches and quiz session, etc. It's the first good thing, gift from Christmas Club. And second is, whenever I join Christmas Club, I could learn many things. Lessons or motivations, especially to study English better, harder and harder. So now I have many English friends on the phone here, from here, and also I could get the book club information from them. So yeah, it gave me a lot of motivation to study English harder and harder. So I have the confidence to master English. So I will really be a member forever. It's my plan. Good morning, visual masters, and welcome the rest. Now, let's think about our brain. During our whole lives, how many percentages of our brain's abilities do you think we use? Studies said we use only a very small part of them. And also, even a genius like Einstein used only 10% of his. Then, how can we develop our brain's potential abilities? Studies said the answer is to practice our creative imagination power, which is called as the most advanced function and the only tool we can explore the unknown world of our brain. And then, finally, we can use our brain's abilities more than 10%. Then, how does our imagination affect our body? And how does the information stored in our brain affect us, the humans? Now, I tell you one news article carried on the newspaper. It is a real story, not fake. One of the American medical centers conducted an experiment to discover the relationship between our imagination and our body. They visited one prison and then asked the death penalty prisoners whether they could assist in their experiment project or not. The project was about measuring how much blood is shed from our human's body until we reach our death. They suggested that any volunteer for the experiment would have $1 million for their family members. And then they described the whole procedure of the experiment to them in detail in advance, like this. We will cut your four arterial blood vessels and then put the blood in a container, checking constantly the amount of blood to see when you lose your consciousness and when your heart stops. But you will be put under local anesthesia, so you will not feel any pain. There were three volunteers. So they put each of them on a bed separately, and then tied their arms and legs, and then showed all the operational cells they blindfolded their eyes. In this situation, the researchers put on an act. In fact, they did not actually cut the volunteers' arterial blood vessels. They just pretended to do so with a dull edge of a knife. And also the sound of blood droppings was created with water drops. But the three volunteers were filled with so much fear, so they could not realize this real situation. What is the result? Can you guess the result then? Can you guess?
They died.
Yes. They died. Oh. You are smart. Very surprisingly and incredibly, they were all dead. Without dropping even one drop of blood. It's a real story. Why? Because without any doubt, the three persons just simply and absolutely believed what the researchers said to them and that they would die. It is so shocking, isn't it?
Yes.
It is the great power of our brains and imagination. Studies said our brain does not matter whether the information is true or not, because our brain cannot distinguish between our imagination and our reality. So, if we just innocently believe anything we imagine is true, without any doubt, whether it is positive or negative, it will absolutely and really become in reality. During your lives, every day, which side will you imagine, positive or negative? Thank you.
Thank you. What a inspiring, what a such an inspiring speech. I haven't really expected